Does Orange still make credible bikes? By which I mean, is there still a reason to buy a single pivot bike made from aluminium when there are dozens of brands making excellent bikes from lighter and stiffer carbon fibre? In 2019, is there still a place for the Oconic 5 and Alpine 6? And does it make sense to pay a premium for an alloy bike? To make those questions easy to answer, Orange has just launched updated versions of both 27.5-inch bikes, featuring some pretty interesting changes. The Alpine and the 5 now have 5mm more travel each. It might not sound like much, but it keeps them relevant, and it takes the 5 up to 145mm travel, and the Alpine 6 up to 165mm travel. Orange told us the 5 had traditionally outsold the Alpine 6, but now it was a more even split between the trail bike and the enduro bike. Orange has also reworked all the tubing on both bikes, giving them a sleeker look and also allowing for the new metric shock sizing and the extra eye-to-eye length they demand. The classic silhouettes of the 5 and the Alpine remain pretty much the same, but up close the bikes look sleeker and I think better. There's a new paint job where the graphics are now under the top layer of lacquer, and the cable routing is neater and less obtrusive too. They've also added bottle bosses, although not where you might want to see them. They're under the down tube. Cue the complaints that your bottle will get covered in SH1T. Orange hasn't missed the chance to tweak and modernise the geometry and sizing of the bikes either, dropping the extra small size and adding an XXL size. That gives the XL5 I rode 10mm more reach and a measurement of 483mm. That's exactly the same size as an XL Santa Cruz Bronson, to put that into some perspective for you. So I rode both the XL5 and the XL Alpine 6 at the launch in Punta Ala in Italy. And while I wasn't cramped in the cockpit, I reckon I could have gone up a size to an XXL, and that would have better suited my 6'1" frame. Both bikes are longer, lower, and slacker than their predecessors. The BB has been dropped by 5mm, both bikes have had half a degree locked off their head angles, and the chainstays are longer on both bikes too. Orange has worked hard to stiffen up the bikes too, adding 10mm to the width of the main pivot. The most important change though is to make the bike's suspension more progressive. As a result, they're both more fun and easier to ride. Pushing the 5 and the Alpine 6 into the trail is instantly more gratifying, as the bike lets you pump and pop it for speed. The Alpine 6 is a big bike in terms of travel and length, but you never feel like a passenger on it. In our experience, Orange bikes live for steep, loose trails, and the 5 and the Alpine 6 are no different. The flex of the alloy frame really works to your advantage, helping to control the bike rather than having you ping off into the bushes. Add to that the extra travel and those geometry changes, and you have some sizable improvements. Is there still a place for the Alpine 6 and the 5 then? Yes, in a word. Orange has made two good bikes that are still relevant and ride well. Perhaps because they're made from aluminium.